Okay, class, today the video that I attached here is regarding the review for quiz chapter 13, which is the symbol probability. Okay, 同学们，今天的这一个 video 呢是关于第十三课的这一个简单的几率的这一个问答题。所以在这个 quiz 里面呢，总共有20题，你们都需要完整的回答。所以现在呢，我们来讨论这一些题目。Okay, the first question. Alright, the first question. You flip a coin 20 times and record the results. Is this experimental or theoretical probability? Okay, probability 就是几率。所以现在你把一个钱币 flip a coin, 抛20次 20 times.And record the result. 所以每抛一次呢，你就记录下来。Every time you flip the coin, you will record. You get a hit or a tail, hit or tail. So this one we call experimental probability. 这个是实验性的几率，因为是通过我们做的活动而带出这个结果。OK, 所以通过这个活动带出来的结果呢，我们叫 experimental probability.If theoretical means from theory, okay, 就是来自一个原理。比方说，如果我抛一枚钱币，我会拿到公的可能性是二分之一，那么那个就是 theoretical probability, okay, 因为一枚钱币只有两面，不是公就是母，所以你会拿到其中一面的可能性就是二分之一，50%的几率，对不对？所以这个是跟着原理的推测，就是 theoretical。可是这边他跟我们说，我们做20次的实验，所以这个就是 experimental probability, okay, so hopefully the first question you're able to understand and differentiate between experimental and theoretical probability. Okay, next. Next we have number two, an or a what is an activity involving chance in which results are observed. Chance means probability. Chance 就是机会，几率 probability.那么如果这个几率呢是从一个活动里面拿到的话，那么这个活动我们称为什么？ So this activity that can cause a result regarding the probability, this activity will call as experiment. Okay, 所以这个活动我们称为实验，就好像刚才第一题这样子，我抛一枚钱币20次，这一个活动呢就是我们的 experiment, 我们的实验。Okay,And next, number three, or and what is the result of a trial? Result. If a result means what? Result means outcome. Okay, 我们会得到的结果，结果就是 outcome. 比如说你抛一枚钱币，你会得到什么 result? When you toss a coin, what is the result you're able to get? So the result we call outcomes. So the outcome thatpossible for us to get when we flip a coin is either hit or tail. 所以当我们抛一枚钱币，我们可以拿到的可能性，那个成果呢，就是不是公就是母。Okay, so this is what we call result outcome. Okay, next, number four. Okay, number four. So number four, we have or and what is all the possible outcomes of an experiment. Okay, so for sure not about experiment, not about outcome. So left sample space and event. 所以什么东西是一个实验有可能的结果？所以刚刚 result 就是 outcome, 一个 experiment 的 result 就是 outcome. Okay, 所以同学我再帮你整理一下，一个活动我们称为 experiment, an activityWe call experiment. From the experiment, we have the result, and the result we call outcome. 所以如果从那个实验里面我们拿到的成果，那个叫 outcome. 那么这个 outcome 呢，所有的可能性我们叫做 sample space. All the possible outcome we call sample space. If you still remember, sample space we will write in a set notation. Okay?所以你如果还记得的话 ，sample space 呢，我们是写在一个 curly bracket 里面的，还记得吗 ？OK, for example, I we have an experiment. 我们有一个 experiment. The experiment is flip a coin for 10 times. 那个活动呢，就是我们抛那个钱币十次. So the outcome will be either we will get head or we will get tail. This is the result from the experiment outcome. Okay, and the possible outcome that we call sample space is in curly bracket, head and tail. Okay, 所以这一个就是如何区分 experiment outcome 跟 sample space. Okay, next number 5, or and what is the result of an experiment? Result. Okay, usually referring to desired result. Desired result 就是我有条件性的。 在于我的成果上面，我要有条件性的。所以上一堂课老师讲过，有条件性的呢，我们称为什么？Event. Okay. If the result of an experiment in certain condition 在某些条件之下，那么这个我们叫 event. Okay. Next number 6. Okay. What is the probability of spinning a even number? Even number means 2, 4, 6, and so on. 双数, even number. Okay? 所以我们就要看, when we form probability, we must have a fraction. 当我们要形成一个几率的时候, 我们要有一个分数. 分数的分母, 如果你记得的话, 应该是什么? 有多少个可能性? The total probability. Okay? 所以分母呢, 在这边我们总共会有 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 6个可能性. We have 6 probability, sorry, 6 possible outcome when we spin this number chart. So we have 6. Okay, and now we need to have even number only. Even number. So from this card, how many even number? We have 2, 4, 6. So altogether 3 over 6. Okay, but this one is not your answer. As I always emphasize that whenever you mention your answer in fraction, must make it to the lowest term. 所以六分之三还不是我们最终的答案，因为老师每次强调分数的话呢，答案必须越减。所以越减过后呢， your answer will be 1/2. Okay, 所以呢，当你旋转这个轮盘的时候，你会拿到双数的可能性呢是一半50%. Okay. Next, number 7. What is the probability? Okay, same. Probability means we need to form a fraction. Spinning a prime number. Okay, if you still remember prime number means a number that can only divide by itself and 1. Prime number cannot divide by others' number. 所以同学，如果你还记得 form 1你学过的 prime number 就是 某些号码只能够除1和它自己本身，不能够被其他号码除的，这个我们叫 prime number。所以每次老师都说呢， prime number呢是一个自私的号码，因为它不可以和其他的号码分享。Okay, so now we check how many possible outcome we have. 我们总共有6个可能性，对不对？所以分母是6。 And how many prime number we have? So prime number 1 is not prime number. 2, yes. Okay, because 2 cannot divide by others' number. 2不可以除其的号码, 所以2是自私的. 3, yes. 4, no. 4 can divide by 2, so 4 is not a prime number. 4可以被2除, 所以可以被其他号码分享, 它不自私. 5, yes. 6, no. Because 6 can divide by 2, 6 also can divide by 3. So how many prime number we have here? We have 3. And once again, cut it to the lowest term, so we have 1/2. Alright? Okay, next question, number 8. What is the probability of spinning number 7? So once again, we need to form probability, form a fraction. So how many possible outcome? Altogether, we have 6 possible outcome. Okay, 分母就是我们总共会有的可能性, 所以有6个号码. 那么从这一个 轮盘里面，如果我们要转到7号， 这边有7号吗？ Is there a 7 on here? No, right? So, there's no 7 here. Means the probability to get 7 is 0. 所以在转这个轮盘的时候，我们要拿到七的几率呢是零，不可能零。为什么？因为轮盘上面没有七号。Okay, so we are not able to get 7 when we spin this card wheel because there's no 7 on there. Alright, next, number 9. Find the probability, again, so we form a fraction of rolling greater than 1 on a single die. Single die 就是一粒骰子。所以当我们抛一粒骰子的时候，我们要拿到的条件，so this is the event. The event is you get a number which is greater than 5. So class, what are those number on a single die? 所以同学们，你就要想一想，在一个骰子上面，我们会有的号码是什么？ Okay, so the possible outcome we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So we have 6 number. So 6 possible outcome.Okay, and to get the number which is greater than 1, so what number is greater than 1? 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. All these are greater than 1. So we have 5 of them. And check, this fraction already in the lowest term. So our answer, 5 over 6. Okay, 所以就是这样子形成那个 probability, 很简单。Okay, next, number 10. Find the probability. Again, find the probability.Okay, of not rolling a 2 on a single die. Okay, 这一次呢，我们要找的几率就是，当我们抛一颗骰子的时候，不要拿到二。So we have two way. Okay, all the possible outcome we have is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And if we don't want 2, so what are those numbers we have? We will still have...1, 3, 4, 5, 6, another 5 possible. So 5 over 6. Okay. Or another way you can do is, okay, another way that you can do is, okay, probability to get 2 when you roll a single die is 1 over 6. Okay. 所以另外一个方式呢，就是我们从抛一颗骰子那边要拿到2号呢，是六分之一的几率。现在我不要I don't want 2. So I will use 1 minus 1 over 6 and I will get 5 over 6. So you see, different method but the same answer goes to. Okay? 所以不同的方式可是我们会拿到同样的答案。Okay, so either you can use the first method or the second method by using the complementary probability. Okay, next, number 11. Okay, number 11, what we have? Probability...can between what two numbers? 几率会出现在什么号码之间? Okay, just now there's a question that can we get 7 when we throw a dice? 刚刚有一题就是当我抛一颗骰子的时候可以拿到七吗? Can't get 7, right? So the possibility is 0. Okay, and the smallest probability is 0. 最小的几率就是不可能零。那么最大的几率呢是什么 ？The biggest probability is 1, because all the probability in form of fraction. So if in term of fraction, the biggest fraction can be is all in 1. Okay, 明白吗，同学？在几率里面，几率呢，我们每次写成分数，对不对？那么在分数里面，最大的形式，最大呢就是一个整数，就是一。所以几率呢是出现在零和一之间，零和一之间。Okay, not 0 and 100. If 0 and 100 means that one is we call percentage. 如果和零一百之间呢，就是%率。Okay, so the answer is 0 and 1. 所以记得最小的几率是零，最大的几率就是一。Okay.Next, number 12, what is the probability of spinning red? Okay, 同样的，我们要找 probability 一个分数，我要转到红色，所以我们有看多少个可能性 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 parts. And all these 5 parts, all in red. That means all 5 in red. So when we cut it to the lowest 1, okay?So this example show us the biggest probability that we can achieve, which is 1. 所以这一题呢，显示给我们看最大的几率呢，我们会拿到一。 就是全部种完。Okay? Next, number 13. What is the probability of spinning green? Okay, so we have to see total how many parts. 首先我们要做分母，分母呢就是有多少个部分。1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So all together we have 12 parts. From the 12 parts, how many are green? Here we have 1, 2, 3. 3 parts in green. Okay, so once again, cut the fraction to the lowest term. That we divide by 3, we get 1. Divide by 3, we get 4. So 1 over 4. Okay, next, number 13. What is the probability of spinning red? Okay, so once again, we check how many parts we have. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So 12 as the denominator. So we wish to get red. Red is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 parts out of the total 12 parts. So 5 over 12 already in the lowest term, so our answer 5 over 12. Okay, next, number 15. The letters that form the word algebra are placed in a bowl. Okay, what is the probability of choosing a letter other than A? Other is very important, students. 这一题呢，它的陷阱落在 other 这边。Okay, after I check all the quiz that you had answered, I found most of you trapped on this question because of the word other. 然后我发现有蛮多的同学在这一题呢答不上，主要就是没有注意到这个关键字眼 other. Other 就是除了。Okay, 所以在一个碗里面，我们放了一些字卡，这些字卡呢就是 algebra 这些字卡。Okay, so how many card we have? How many card we have? Algebra, A-L-G-E-B-R-A. All together, how many words? We have 7 words. From these 7 words, how many alphabet are not A? Other than A means not A. Okay, so we have 7 cards. And cut another 2A. So we have 5 cards which is not A. So 5 over 7. Okay, so this question, the answer is 5 over 7. Because we want probability that are not A. Other than A, not A. Okay, number 16. The letter that form the word mathematics are placed in a bowl. What is the probability of choosing a vowel? Okay, hopefully you still remember what is the vowel. So since we need to form fraction, we need to find out the probability, so we form a fraction. Okay, denominator, 分母, how many words together, how many letters? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So all together, 11 letters from mathematics. And we need vowel. Vowel means what? A, E, I, O, U. So A, E-A-I. Okay, vowel, A-E-I-O-U. So 4 of them. So 4 over 11. Again, you check, yes, lowest term. Okay, and now we move on. Question 17. A spinner had a 1 over 5 chance. This 1 over 5 means probability. 这一题的五分之一呢，就是它的几率。Of landing on green. 所以要拿到青色的呢，你要转那个轮卡。OK? 转到拿青色的几率呢是五分之一。How many times is this event likely to occur if you repeat 85 times? OK? 所以它的几率呢是五分之一。The probability is 1 over 5. And all together we try how many times? 85 times. 总共我们试了85次。OK? So we need to find out.How many parts are green color? 所以在这85次里面有多少个是青色的? So what should we do? Yes, we do ratio. Okay, proportion that you learn in Form 1. 我们就找出来这一个。5 multiply what to get 85? Multiply 17. So if the denominator multiply 17, numerator also multiply 17. 所以分母呢，我们找出是乘17，那么分子也跟着乘17，所以 your answer will be 17. Okay, means from 85 times, you get 70 times green. So 17 over 85, you make it to the lowest, you will get 1 over 5. 所以同学们, 这一题就是说, 在你旋转那个轮盘 85次里面, 有17次呢, 你是转到青色的。 所以这85分之17呢, 你越减成为1/5. Okay, next number 18. If a bag contain 3 purple, 8 orange, 2 black, and 7 marbles, what is the probability of an orange marble be selected? So once again, probability, so we need to form a fraction. Okay, so we need to find the denominator. Denominator is total. So we have 3 purple, 8 orange, 2 black, 7 white. So we add up, total of marble is 3, add with 8, add with 2, add with 7. So all together we have how many marbles? 20 of them. 所以总共我们有20个珠子。 那么20颗珠子里面我要找出橙色的几率, orange. So orange we have 8 of them. Okay? And then we cut it to the lowest, divide by 4 we get 2, divide by 4 we get 5. So answer 2 over 5. Okay, next, number 19. Based on a survey, a company claims that 35% of their customers are dissatisfied with their products. Of the 1,500 responses, you would expect customers to be satisfied. Okay, so you have 1,500, 1,500个人里面你做survey,你做一个调查, okay, they will be satisfied, satisfied就是满意, dissatisfied不满意. 所以 dissatisfied will be 35%, 不满意的人呢有35%. So we need to find how many customer that satisfied. 我们要找出多少个人满意的. So what should we do? Okay, usual way that we do is we use should be all together 100%, right? So we use 100% minus 35% and we found that there will be 65% which are satisfied. Sorry, which are satisfied. Okay, 所以我们用100%减掉那35%不满意的，我们会找到呢有65%人是满意的。那么这65%人是来自哪里？来自这1500人。 So what should we do? We use 1,500 multiply the 65%. 65% because satisfied. Okay, so what you get? What you get? You cut the zero here. So your answer will be how much? You try to use the calculator. Okay, if you wish to use your calculator, 65. Okay, 65 multiply 35. Sorry, 65 multiply 15, you get 975. Okay, 975. Okay, next, the last question that we are going to discuss for this quiz. Okay, we have here, Mark collect antique coins from different countries. We have 10 from Spain, 20 from Australia, 15 from Germany, and 5 from Japan. If all of Mark coins are placed in a bag, what is the probability that he will randomly pick a coin not from Australia? Okay, so I show you the first way we do this is, first we form the probability that the coin from Australia. So to form the probability, we must have total. So total is 10, add with 20, add with 15, add with 5. Okay, so how much we have? 50. Am I right? Okay, from Australia, Australia is 20. So we cut it to the lowest. The probability that the coin from Australia is 2 over 5. But now is, I don't want the coin from Australia, not from Australia. Okay, so complementary probability that, okay, of Australia. So I will use 1 minus 2 over 5, which I will get 3 over 5. So okay, which I will get 3 over 5. So this is the answer, 3 over 5. Or you can use another method. Another method is you can try to do, okay, straight away, not from Australia. Okay, then total that we found just now is 50. So not Australia, we don't want this one. We only want 10 from Spain, 15 from Germany, 5 from Japan. So we get how much? We get 30. So cut it to the lowest. Yes, 3 over 5. Same answer we have. So either straight away you find the probability of the coin not from Australia, or you find the complementary probability. Okay, so students, these are the discussion of the quiz from chapter 13 regarding symbol probability. Hopefully you gain knowledge from here, okay, and you know what is the mistake that you done on your quiz. Okay, thanks so much.